We're getting ready for me to sail across the Atlantic.
And Andre and Jack just arrived as well yesterday. So we've got the whole crew here. They're going to help us over the next week do some boat jobs.
A stack of jobs to get ready.
And then we're going to try and get in a little sail trip before you go. Like a little going away party, I guess. Me and Lenny are going to fly, spend some time with my friends, Sophia and Tom.
Yep.
And meet Riley in Antigua. That's the plan.
Mm-hmm.
I'm Elayna and this is Riley. And this is our home, La Vagabond. We've been sailing around the world for the last 6 years now. And recently, it's like we're seeing everything for the first time through a new set of eyes. This is our little boy, Lenny. Click the subscribe button to join our voyage every Monday. Welcome back, guys. Just quickly, if you missed last week's episode, we sailed down to Tenerife from the island of Madeira. And Riley's about to sail over this big chunk of water so that we can get our home back into some beautiful tropical weather again. Okay, now you're up to speed. Let's carry on, shall we?
We haven't spoken about, like, why aren't you coming?
Riley wants to do a single-handed sail. Really tough with Lenny. We just sit down for 2 weeks. I think we'd both be happier if we were running around somewhere. And I'm pregnant. It's good for me to be moving around and not just sitting down the whole time. And you guys know I've been getting more seasick since I've been pregnant. So I'm going to skip this one. I feel like I can, though. I mean, I've done 3 Atlantic crossings now. I'm happy to sit this one out. I can retire now. So, Jack. G'day, mate.
How you going?
Where have you come from?
I've just sailed down from France on a Swan 82 doing a delivery from Antibes in the south of France to Tenerife here.
Mm-hmm.
It was awesome.
Do you feel the deja vu?
Yeah, back on La Vaga, back in. This is actually where it all began.
Yeah.
I joined in, I flew to Tenerife and then we started in Lanzarote.
Yeah.
It's cool to be back.
Yeah, 6 years ago.
Oh my gosh. Time flies, it feels like yesterday.
Yeah, cool.
Now I've got somebody to help me scrub on the boat, so that's handy.
He's very helpful.
Very helpful.
And we got Dre back. What have you been doing?
Some sailing, I bought a boat, I'm fixing it, and university, a lot.
Tell us more about your boat.
It's a 1964 crappy small boat that I saw a lot of potential, and I'm bringing it from the dead.
Nice.
Okay.
What did you just do?
I've decided to make it shorter.
Yeah, that'll do.
Damn, look at those legs.
Everything's pretty good. It wasn't long since I did my last one, but I'm still gonna send Andre up to check one out as well. And maybe even Jack. Gotta shorten a few things. There's a few little things we gotta do up here, but all in all, it's looking very good. This is the mainsail halyard. I've just shortened that. That's a job we gotta do every year, a little bit less. And then had a look all around everywhere just to make sure nothing's out of order and nothing is out of order. We're all good. So yeah, I'm gonna head back down now.
It always starts raining when someone's up the mast.
So there's friction on one, so when I turn the wheel one way, there's lots of friction. When I turn the other, it's just beautiful. So we've disassembled the inside, we've pulled the cupboard apart, we're looking down here, and we're just listening, and I feel like we can hear it here, where the friction is emanating, the source.
And you thought it was plastic deeper down where you couldn't get to, but now what's your thoughts?
Now I don't know. I'm gonna jump down in here. Do you wanna go into the starboard side one? We spent the day looking for the problem with the steering. We decided that we'd poke our feelers around the boatyard to try and find another fresh set of eyes to have a look at it on the manana.
Coming back to the house. It's actually pretty hard living both on the boat and on the house because we've always forgotten something or we need something which is in the other place. don't recommend. How cold is it?
Crazy.
Really?
It's so good though. It's amazing.
Cheers. Cheers to have you back, Shmoo.
We've just taken all of the roofing panels off to follow these lines here. And then we've also had some mechanics here to look at the steering because myself, Jack and Andre couldn't figure it out. And there was one little piece of plastic that they managed to jam out and then they lubricated it as well. So yeah, the steering is better, but during that we found another problem down the back there, which I'll show you now. So that is part of the steering assembly. You definitely don't want to be crossing the Atlantic with that, with so much play here. So this is the rudder post, and that will go down to the rudder, which actually controls the steering of the vessel, which is unbelievably important. Like the apart from keeping water out of the boat, the second thing you need to be able to do is steer the vessel. We definitely have to fix it and maybe reinforce it, like by bringing a light, like a plank of wood up here to stop it from moving up. But yeah, there's quite a bit of play, probably, if we're really rough with it, might be a centimeter of play, probably not, probably half a centimeter of play. I'm really glad that we found that now. We're gonna have to fiberglass that. That's the main thing that we have to do, is re-fiberglass that part and then maybe add some extra supports in there. And then we've got the autopilot. This is the backup spare autopilot, which we're gonna install. We'll pull it apart and hopefully get that done.
I think it was the smaller one.
Riley's had some problems with his clicker and his clacker up there. It looks like this might have been the issue.
So we've got to find a new clicker.
See how these pawls should be popping out nice and free. It should be nice and clean. Looks like the spring in there might be a bit gunked up or something. Not an expert. Definitely not an expert. Reiterate, not an expert. We're hoping it's just to pull apart and clean and put back together and maybe it works. Yeah, that's how it's supposed to sound, though. Much better than that.
So Ultramur have kindly offered to get this done under warranty, which will only be, I think it'll be €300 or something. So the mechanics are coming in here and they've half done this job. So Jack and myself and Andre are getting on with the Jenica, which I tore, and then the sailmaker couldn't get it undone because when I furled it up, it was hourglassed. So we're gonna take that to the Airbnb and put it on the lawn there and try to take tension either side, get it tight, and then unfurl it.
Everything should be loose now.
Loose, much looser, yeah. And we're gonna start doing this. So that we can fold it up and get it to the sailmaker so that they can then sew the corner back on, hopefully. And then we've got the spare autopilot and a few other jobs to still do. But it's good that we don't have to do the fiberglassing one. So I'm just in contact with BNG because the alarm for the high wind speed has been coming on prematurely, which I need for single-handed sailing. I need to have a high wind alarm, and I've had to go into the system and that's had a control to do with the dampening of the wind, which is another setting, but then that affects the autopilot settings. And when we're, especially when we're surfing down waves. So I'm in contact with them to try and figure out the best solution. This is a pelagic autopilot, which I'm gonna use as a backup. This is the actuator. So it's just gonna operate off the tiller. And I like the idea because it's powerful enough to, according to these guys, to handle our boat. If we were in the case that we were to be struck by lightning and some systems went off and somehow I was still able to have a little bit of power, I'd be able to have the pull this out from underneath the bed and then hook it up. So it's just like an extra special backup autopilot, which is, for a single-handed sailor, that's like hugely important. Hugely, hugely important. We want to, I haven't read the manual yet, but we want to drill this into the wall here, probably like that, and have that sitting down there, and have this hooked up to the tiller. This actuator will be our autopilot, and the arm will come out of here. Then there's power, so we need a wire run through here somewhere, and that's what we're looking at underneath, and then behind this, under this seat here, and we're trying to find the wire run so that we can follow it to the battery, and it's hard.
Okay, go starboard.
What are we doing here, Andre?
We're going to try to seal the emergency hatch because it's leaking, and then the bilge is always filled on this side. So that's
the seal
that
there.
We cannot put.
Yeah, we can. That's why we're using a light glue.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So I could punch it open if I needed to, but it should be waterproof.
Mm-hmm.
Because obviously, okay. Yeah, you don't want to glue shut the,
the emergency
hatch. So we're just using this shitty glue here. So I should be able to headbutt the window open if there's a problem.
Hope so. We can't open it already.
You can see what the problem is. Of course there's going to be a sealing issue. These rubbers would be very difficult to get even and have it sit properly, and you can feel it doesn't want to close there. When you're down here, Andre, you're going to have to really dry it. That's already wet, and stick a real lot of glue down the bottom here. But that's already wet, so you need to prep that nicely. With the steering sorted, fiberglassing done, winches serviced, rig inspection done, the backup autopilot installed, it was time for us to have a bit of a break.
You won't come to Tenerife.
Thanks, mate.
You're welcome, sir.
What do you reckon about that, Jack?
Let's go.
A big thanks to Simon from Now Tenerife for hooking us up with a scooter and a car.
How cool is this town?
It's pretty cool. I'm grinning ear to ear, but no one can see.
We're in the town of Santa Cruz because I have my 14 and a half week scan. So we're just walking to our appointment. We left the boys in the city centre, and you're going to see the baby for the first time.
I am. Yeah. There's one in here as well.
Yeah, that one is bigger actually. The one in there is much bigger.
Can you see the baby?
This pregnancy has felt a lot like Lenny's. And besides the fact I get terribly seasick, I've been feeling amazing day to day. Fatigued sometimes, but I really can't complain at all. We cannot wait to see Lenny as a big brother.
Oh, some lady forgot her purse at the table, so I was like running down the street and I was like, I hope it's the right person, somebody else.
You look like you had stolen the purse when you were running with it. So we've just stopped at a little park on the way back to the car. My appointment went really well at the doctor's. I'm going to get the gender test and also all the other tests that you need to check for disease and stuff like that. And he had his suspicions as to what sex it was. I'm not gonna say because I'm not 100% and I want to do a surprise for you guys, but oh my gosh. Oh.
Tractor!
Oh, he's so happy.
There's room in the back. Everyone.
What's happening, babe?
Nothing.
Riley lost the ticket and we can't get out. This lost ticket has cost us half an hour of our time. Late, we want to go home to sleep. It's a 55-minute drive home. Is that for us?
And she said, don't push the door.
Oh, okay.
They're watching it.
Today was going to be another really good day, starting with a morning walk, followed by paragliding with our friends, and then we were going to go check out this volcano called El Teide, which we saw when we were sailing into Tenerife, and it looked pretty incredible. So we've found our friends again. We got Sophia over here.
Hi!
You guys met them in Horta. We met some friends, Tom and Sophia. They have a little boy that's the same age as Lenny. So we've been hanging out, and he's actually a paraglider.
Good morning.
Tom has offered to take Riley for another tandem flight, but first you're going to test.
Yeah, I'm going to fly alone first.
Yeah, okay.
Check the area. Look, there's someone digging up.
Stand side off. Yeah, I've got Sophie in front by a lot here.
What do you think, Jack?
I've seen them off in the distance before, but never up close. This is so cool.
It's ridiculous, isn't it?
So cool.
It never gets old. Even after 8 years, every time I watch them, I'm like a kid. I'm so excited.
Okay, here we go again.
Hey, Lenny boy!
Lenny.
Here he comes! Oh!
That's pushing.
A shout out to our friends Tom and Sophia again. You can follow them and watch them live a kind of parallel life to us over on Instagram. We love these guys.
Not scared.
I know exactly what I'm doing, setting this harness up.
Yeah, well, you're gonna make sure you do, because Tom won't check.
I don't want to fall out of the sky.
No, of course Tom will check, mate.
And I'll tell you 1, 2, 3, and at 3 we start running. And yep. You have to push, because basically what it will do, it's a bit surprising the first time, but it really, really goes like this, you know.
Okay.
Strong.
Okay, so we've got it like lean
yeah,
forward.
Yeah, you resist.
Like some sort of rugby player.
Yeah.
Just taken off. It was kind of petrifying. Now we're flying, and this is unreal, the most amazing perspective of the world I've ever seen. Oh, dude.
Go find Tom and Jack. Have landed down the hill. How was it?
Amazing. One of the coolest things I've ever done for sure.
Yay, weren't expecting that today.
No, not at all.
How was
Jack
it?
Jack said he was going to start playing.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. For sure. Yeah.
He hooked?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what Riley
it's
said
like
too.
It's like sailing in the sky.
What have you done, Tom?
That's not the first time.
Thank you.
Wow, this is sick.
Certainly the biggest mountain in Tenerife and potentially the largest mountain in all of Spain.
And we're gonna head back to the house with the heater on. Go and eat some dinner. Heater.
That is great footage right there.
What's the dinner, Jack?
My famous broccoli, lemony, almondy, chili, garlicky.
Oh, there's
pasta.
Chili?
Well, I'm growing chili from Antibes, from a famous sailor.
When did he give that to you?
When I was in Antibes just before getting down here.
So you carry chilies with you?
I'm bringing chilies everywhere I go, just in case.
Have it. Are they super hot?
We'll see. We've always got to be prepared.
Showing us some videos of ice falling out of the sky. So there's a massive blow there at the moment, which is causing 7 meter waves.
Wow.
Beauty.
Which are coming down to greet us here tomorrow at 9 a.m. It's not so bad, but it's probably the worst time in the last couple of weeks that we could have chosen to leave.
I think we should give people what they want to see, some rough.
Yeah, we're going to give you guys some rough weather, that's what you've been saying. I want to see you guys in rough weather.
So, I mean, it's just going to be sporting.
How much wind is forecast?
It's just changed. On my phone, which I downloaded before, it was gusting to 25 and now it's 17.
Only gusting to 17.
Well, it's
what's wind, the forecast?
Wind speed of 16, gusting to 17.
That's wow. Fine. That's fine. Right, we're sailing from Tenerife to La Gomera. I have no idea how many miles it is.
40.
There you go, 40 miles. La Gomera, actually, home of the whistling language. That's all I know.
Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends and all that jazz. And join us next week for Riley's going away party before he sets sail across the Atlantic. We go for a sail to a nearby island and we also celebrate little Lenny's birthday.